Meanwhile, back here at home, the Democrats might have a new party platform. If you can't beat them, sue them.
Well, the DNC filing a lawsuit against the Trump campaign, against Russia and WikiLeaks, accusing all three of election interference.
Joining us now with his reaction is Alan Dershowitz, Harvard Law Professor Emeritus, lifelong Democrat and author of Trumped Up. But you don't need to be Alan Dershowitz to see that this lawsuit really isn't much.
Well, first, I have to acknowledge that I did represent Julian Assange and WikiLeaks for a short period of time some years ago. I think it's a complicated lawsuit. I think it will be dismissed as to Russia based on sovereign immunity. It will probably be dismissed as to the Republican Party based on political question, but it may go forward as to some of the alleged hackers. But remember, there's reciprocal discovery. So the Democrats will have to produce all the information about the dossier and about other attempts, maybe. You know, this really confirms the view I've said from the beginning. There should have been an objective, neutral, bipartisan commission looking into the Russian role in the election without pointing fingers. Now we have partisan lawsuits and partisan attempts to get the president and get Hillary. That's not going to get us the information.
There are so many lawsuits going around. And speaking of James Comey, because he has been in the news with his book, but the most recent news is the IG looking into his memos for classified info. And the reason this is important, because you remember back in his Senate testimony, June 2017, he said he avoided classified material in those memos so that they could be widely shared. So if they find something more real here, and he was dishonest in that hearing, how bad could that be for James
Comey? Well, again, it's going to be the same thing. They were trying to put Hillary Clinton in jail because there may have been one or two classified pieces of information. Now they're going to try to go after Comey. Look, the only First Amendment case I ever lost, to my knowledge, was I represented Frank Snepp, the former CIA director who wrote a book called Decent Interval. The government went after him, even though there was no classified information, because they said the information was proprietary and owned by the CIA, and he had signed an agreement that he would not write a book without it being approved by the CIA. I think that Comey has some vulnerability there, particularly if there is any classified material. And remember, Comey is a leaker. We know that he leaked information and laundered it through a law professor, which is certainly not something any former head of the FBI should do. The job of the FBI is to stop leaks, not to promote them.
Well, beyond Comey, it seems like there may be a bigger question, which is this whole rotten fruit principle I've heard you talk about many times before. And I'm not a lawyer, but I'm going to let you handle the key. The key is that the president tweeted overnight that, hang on a second, if Comey broke the law by leaking classified information with these memos, with the stated goal of trying to get a special counsel named to investigate the president, is that now tainted?
Well, you know, the fruit of the poison tree is a limited doctrine. It applies basically to illegal search and seizures. It's a real stretch. It's an interesting metaphor, but it will not result in the dismissal of the special counsel.
So you're saying the horse is out of the barn on this one?
I think the horse is. Well, but, out of the barn for the moment, but I think he's going back in the barn. As I've said right from the beginning, I don't think the president has real worries about Mueller and the investigation of alleged collusion or obstruction of justice. Where he ought to be focusing his attention, I'm not his lawyer, but where he ought to be focusing his attention is New York, Cohen, whether Cohen flips, whether he sings, whether he composes. That's the fear. You know, if you're innocent, you don't worry about a singer. But even if you're innocent, you have to worry about a composer, somebody who creatively elaborates on the story, because the better the story, the better.
What about Rudy Giuliani being added to the
list? I think it's a great idea. Look, Rudy and I have fought each other for years. He was always a prosecutor. I was a defense attorney. He's a Yankee fan.
Yeah.
I'm a Red Sox fan.
That's just mean.
You did that on purpose.
I did. Although I love Rudy.
That's just mean to Ed and
I know, but when I sit in back of him on Red Sox-Yankee games, I always wear this tie. So I wore it today to remind Rudy that we still have some differences between us, though I think he's going to do
a great
job.
But quickly, you advise the president. There's so much going on with these FBI officials.
I only say what I think on television.
But if you had to give him your own thoughts, you say sit back, let all this play out. Enough is being done. You don't have to do anything?
Absolutely. Don't tweet, don't pardon, don't fire, and don't testify, and I think you'll be fine.
Mr. Dershowitz, as always, a pleasure. Thank you very much.
Good
great
to have you.
Mayor Giuliani, if you want to come on and defend the Yankees or talk about the legal case, you're invited, by the way.
Wear a full pinstripe suit. All right.